All right, let's do it. First question, right here.
With Tampa Bay coming up short this year after being favored to contend for a Super Bowl, what would you say the overall issues were with this team this season?
How much time you got, buddy? Where would I start? Well,
I mean, it's a lot. First off, I can say that we fucked up. Let me just say that much. We fucked up.
Jotaro, we fucked up. What are you gonna say? We fucked up.
Then somehow we fucked up.
We fucked up.
We fucked up.
Man, this is so much. I can't believe the season's over. This season was not supposed to go like this. I'm not gonna assign any percentage or anything like that, but I mean, let's just be honest. We have an offensive line that was decimated since the second day of training camp. We lost our center, Jensen, one of the best centers in the entire league. Lost him the second day of training camp, tore every damn ligament and muscle, and just his shit was a wreck. No surgery, just straight rehab and just, you know, getting back right. Unfortunately, didn't get him back until, you know, tonight's game, playoff game, unfortunately. We needed him back, though, and he helped a little bit, but still, I mean, too little too late. Offensive line decimated all year. Every one of our offensive linemen, I think with the exception of the right guard, if I'm not mistaken, at this point doesn't fucking matter, but all of them missed at least one game, you know, and the continuity's not there, right? What can you do if you don't have the continuity, right? So we're having second, third, fourth string guys, right? One guy goes down, somebody has to fill in for him. Well, shit, that fill-in, somebody's got to fill in for that fill-in. It's a big mess and no continuity, and that's where it starts. I don't care who your quarterback is. I don't care if your quarterback is a 20-year-old stud.
Now, Lotto stud.
Or a 45-year-old goat. That's a statue. Can't move for shit, right? If your offensive line's not there, you don't have it. Same thing with the defensive line. It starts up front. Your defensive line isn't strong, guess what? Those guys in the back, your linebackers and secondary guys, guess what? They can't cover forever. They can't cover zones, and they can't run with their man forever. It starts up front. But couple that with the fact that you have a quarterback who's 76 years old. He's got one move, right? He needs to be able to step up into that pocket. He needs to have a clean pocket, but he needs to be able to, if shit gets, you know, he needs to be able to step up into it, find somebody, and make a throw. Every now and again, he might can scoot to the right or left, but don't expect that shit. He doesn't need to be, he needs, at this age, he needs a clean pocket. He's never been a scrambling quarterback, but he needs a clean pocket to throw. You know, he can make throws under duress and all that shit, but still, at this age, we need some continuity. And yes, he took the least sacks of any quarterback in the league this year. I don't know how that was possible, but still, you got quarterback pressures, you got quarterback hits. I mean, you know, did he just fuck up sometimes and just make fucked up throws? Yes, he did. He did. Tom made some really bad throws. He played, this is probably the worst I've seen him play long damn time.
And I do mean a long damn time.
But due in part to the offensive line. Nobody wants to talk about that. Nobody wants to talk about Tom playing bad because we don't like to see our goats at this play at this shitty of a level when we know they're better than that, right? But he did not play his best football this year. Okay, it's a team effort. Yeah, right? Compliments, one compliments the other and vice versa, right? So, you know, like I said, offensive line, Tom made his shit throws and shit, you know, receivers dropping balls. There was a lot of drop balls this year. I mean, you know, receivers also missed time. It wasn't just the offensive line that was banged up, you know. These guys Receivers missed some time. It's just injuries were aplenty. These last 2 years, injuries were aplenty. You know, the first year of Super Bowl, everybody stayed pretty healthy. I don't think there were any injuries, big injuries for the most part. You know, by the time Super Bowl came, everybody was good to go. So it just, sometimes it just happens like that. But to say that this team is done or that Tom is done, you know. But I mean, like I said, a lot of shit. Offensive line, injuries, coaching. You know, we'll speak about that later. But like I said, just a lot of shit. But we fucked up. So, yeah. Next question.
For so long now, your left tackle Donovan Smith has been criticized for his numerous holding penalties that negate your big plays and your small plays alike. Are there any
Donovan
plans
Smith.
To move him or cut him or anything like
what
that?
What are we going to do about Donovan Smith? Well, I mean, they just gave him some money recently. Well, not recently, but I mean, it's the Super Bowl year, he looked great blocking for Tom. But I mean, let's just be honest, he is a fucking holding machine. If I had to guess, he's probably the most penalized left tackle in the entire league. And I mean, I understand doing parts of the fact that you don't want Tom to get hit. And, you know, left tackle sees some of the best pass rushers week in and week out. So, I mean, I can understand, but at the same time, the dude's a fucking wall. He's massive. These guys can't get around you, man. You gotta stop holding them. You know, Donovan Smith has been holding since before Tom even thought about switching teams, right? A big play happens. Oh, flag. Let me guess. Holding? I don't even need to ask. 76? I knew it. Come on back, you fat fuck. It's a every week thing. And I'm not even exaggerating. I can't remember the last time there was any type of holding penalty to negate a big play or little play. But see, I've been watching this team for a long damn time. Okay? A long damn time. Okay? Donovan Smith loves to hold. Point blank period. He loves to hold. I don't know if he's doing it on purpose. I'm fucking miffed. I'm confused. Unconfuse me. Do you know? Because I don't know. I sit back and I watch this fuck up every week. So, I mean, but what better option of left tackle do we have? That's the question you have to ask yourself. What better option do we have? You know, so, I don't know. Keep him. When he's on, he's on. But he's so inconsistent, I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that. I don't know, as a fan, I sit back and I wait. I sit back and I wait because I know it's coming. It's inevitable, right? It's going to fucking happen. You're going to hold. You're going to hold. Come on, Donovan. Hey, I don't feel right as a fan. I feel unfulfilled if I don't get a holding penalty because I'm just so used to it, right? I'm just so used to it. So, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what we're going to do. I don't know. Hopefully something. Hopefully we'll get it together.
Greetings, Ian Pierre Lachlan from the French Gazette. Would you mind elaborating more on the Baron Leftwich being fired?
It had to happen. It had to happen. You can't have 12 runs in a playoff game and not get fired, right? People say, "Oh well, you know, he took you to the Super Bowl the first year. You know, you guys are scoring 30 plus points a game. Your first 2 years." And now this year, we're scoring 18 points, slightly over 18.4, just 18 points a game. This offense with these weapons, there's too many offensive weapons. Excuse me, too many offensive weapons for this team to not be scoring more than 30 points. See, my problem is he starts off with the run constantly. That's his favorite fucking thing. Start with the run. And if the run seems to not be working, shies away from the run, right? It's bullshit, right? So you have to these motherfuckers until they get it, right? 12 run. You have two running backs. You've got Leonard Fournette. You've got Rashad White. Leonard Fournette, OG, veteran at this point, right? He's no old fucking dog, but he's a veteran, right? And you got the young man Rashad White. You know, the two nice little 1-2 punch. Lenny's the power, Rashad's the speed guy, right? So, and you're deploying these guys a total of 12 times. That's why you're fucking fired. The dude does this shit all year. All year, he does this. Run the fucking ball. There was only a couple games this year where I was like, man, this is how it should be. You know, a 60-40, you know, 45-55, maybe even a 50-50. Motherfucker, not no 80-20, 70-30, 90-10. You know, it simply shouldn't be. It just simply shouldn't be. It's bullshit. 12 fucking runs in a playoff game? Okay? I appreciate his due diligence and his help and his game planning and all that, but this is bullshit. This should not be. 12 runs is unfucking acceptable. Sorry. Somebody has to go. Right? Some other coaches will go. Some other coaches, you know. But yeah, Byron had to go. He had to go. You know, that's one of the reasons Tom, I think, will be coming back. Yep.
Yeah, Ian, you spoke about Byron. Would you speak more to Todd Bowles possibly being fired?
I mean, Todd Bowles, I mean, great defensive mind. I don't know if he's quite ready to be a head coach. Or excuse me, I take that back. I don't want to say it, but he has been a head coach, obviously twice now, but I don't think he is head coach material, right? Too soft-spoken, too meek, not all there. Not Bruce was a little bit more, you know, in your face, kind of tell it what it is. Todd, he wanted to keep Byron around. So that, if that tells you anything, you know. Let's let him stay because the defense is a bright spot of this team. Let's keep him, right? Let's keep him. Work some shit out. Yep. There's just a couple more. I gotta get out of here. So just a couple more. Yep.
So much has been made about Tom's possible retirement or switching teams. Yeah. What do you think about that?
Tom, I mean, it's Tom Brady. I mean, shit. The only two teams can say they've had Tom Brady as the quarterback. And I'm lucky enough to say he played on my team. I love it. I love having him. I hope he stays forever. But, I mean, I know that's not the case. Is he going to come back? I have no idea. I think if you read the tea leaves, everything that he said, and you know, prior seasons, this season, you know, like I said, getting rid of Byron, I think he'll be back because you don't get rid of your family like you fucking killed him or something like that. I mean, you don't go through a divorce and this stuff and then say you have unfinished business and then come back and then for this to be the result, what, 31-14? I mean, that's not what you came back for. So. I think he's coming back one more time. And if you want me to be honest, I think he's going to bring Gronkowski back with him. I do. I think Gronkowski took another year off to see. He already said he called in November and said he was bored and wanted to play. But I guess they just couldn't come to, you know. So I think he'll be back. I think he'll be back. Obviously, I want him back. The video should continue. I mean, if he's back, they will. I'm not sure if I'll do, you know, because I started to do him when he got there because it made the team interesting, right? To say the least, right? It made the team interesting. It made the team fun. You know, people tune in. So it was just something I wanted to do. It's just, I don't know. I just started doing it. So. I think it'll come back. I'm hoping for just one more ride. You know, we only had him for 2 years initially, and I said I just want one. Just give me one Super Bowl, and I'll be happy. So he gave us one. You know, if he wants to get to Steppen, hey, you get to Steppen. I'm still gonna rep it though. I'm still gonna rep it because you know, even though he's a Patriot for life, he was just a rental. You know, the motherfucker, you know, one of the best days of my life. And I also got to see him play in person this year. So that was like seeing a fucking god. And I got to see him right up close too. So it was, wow. but yeah, I want him back. So yeah, just give me one more. And I gotta get out of here. So
plain and simple, Ian, what's it gonna take next year?
What's it gonna take next year? Health. Honestly, this team is. If you watch this team, you know, right? You know, a lot of people don't watch a lot of football. A lot of people don't watch Tampa Bay football. So you know, I see a lot of shit on social media. People getting at me, but you don't know. You don't really know, right? You hate greatness. You want Tom to retire, and why do you want this to be gone so bad? Greatness. Why do we want this great thing to be gone so badly? Because once it's gone, it's gone. We'll never get another Tom, ever. Well, not in this lifetime, right? So every snap, I savor it. I love fucking football. I fucking love it. Your team, my team, I love everything football. You know, that's why I do these videos. That's why I say the things that I say, because I know, right? I'm no expert, but I'm locked in, right? So it's gonna take, like I said, health, good play calling, proper execution, right? You gotta fucking execute. You know, Byron can call whatever he wanted to call, but if we didn't fucking execute it, didn't fucking matter, right? So, and just you know, a little bit of luck, a little bit of luck. This team is not dead. Understand that this team is not fucking dead. Okay, the window. When I say the window, I mean the opportunity to compete, seriously compete for a championship. It's still open. It's closing. It's closing. It's slowly closing. It's still open. All things considered, you give me a healthy offensive line, you give me some adequate play calling, right? Proper play on both sides of the ball, special teams good. We're making another run, considering the division, you know, and the only reason they got in the playoffs this year because the division was so shit, okay? You take that bullshit record and to any other division, done. They're done for. Finished. There's no playoffs to even be had. So, you know, one more run. This team is not dead. Understand me. This team is not fucking done. They're not done. They're not dead. Okay. So that's it. That's a season. And fuck my life. I can't believe it. I can't believe we're to the end. I'm gonna watch the rest of these games and try to make me some money. You know, watch Super Bowl, Pro Bowl, all that bullshit. And feels a little different when your team's not in it. But hey, a little bit of football left. We're gonna enjoy it. So I appreciate y'all watching my videos every week. I really do. I appreciate y'all more than you know. I love this football shit. I fucking love it. I love it. And I'm ready to bait any of you motherfuckers any day of the week. Okay? About your team, my team. I'm gonna give it to you straight up. I'm gonna get you straight up. This season was not great. This season was not great, all things considered. So that's it. I hope to see you again next year. If not, hey, I'm still a Tampa fan regardless. If Tom's here, if he's not here, hey, this is my shit, so they put me in the fucking ground. So, you know, I'll see y'all another time. Peace.
You're still here?
It's over. Go home.